In this video, I'm going to demonstrate the straight leg raise or Lasègue's test for lumbar radiculopathy. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. The straight leg raise test is one of the most commonly used tests in neurological assessment of a patient who displays lumbar radiculopathy symptoms that are commonly caused by disc herniations. These symptoms include radiating pain down the leg, loss of muscle strength, numbness and/or tingling in one or both legs. The straight leg raise test has been evaluated to have a sensitivity of 91% and a specificity of 26% as reported in the systematic review by Devier et al. From the year 2000. To conduct the test, have your patient in supine lying position. Normally, you would start by assessing the unaffected leg first. Then, flex your patient's leg at the hip joint whilst keeping the knee in a fully extended position and ask your patient to inform you once symptoms occur. Normally, you would expect radicular symptoms to occur in the range between 35 to 70 degrees of hip flexion. If pain is elicited past this range, this pain is mostly coming from the lumbar spine or the sacroiliac joint. To further assess the neurological tissue, perform a straight leg raise test until symptoms occur, move out of the painful range, and then either dorsiflex the ankle, which is referred to as the Bragas sign, or ask your patient to maximally flex the neck, which is referred to as the Neri sign. If pain is elicited during any of those two maneuvers, it indicates stretch of the dura mater or a lesion within the spinal cord, which could be caused by disc herniations or a tumor. As I've stated, the literature reports that the straight leg raise test is a very sensitive test that you can use to exclude a lumbar radiculopathy. If you want to confirm your diagnosis, be sure that you also include a thorough patient history, reflex, and muscle testing in your assessment. Okay, this was our video on the straight leg raise test. If you liked it, be sure to give it a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, and subscribe to our channel if you haven't. And if you want, you can check out the slump test, which is another common neurodynamic test, as well as the prone knee bending test. As always, this was Andreas for Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.